Let's suppose that I have a formula for my velocity.
For instance, maybe my velocity at time t is something like 3 minus 10 times t.
With that equation in hand, can I then determine my position, right? Velocity and position are related in some way. The derivative of my position is velocity. Well, let's write that fact down.
P of t is my position at time t. V of t is my velocity at time t. And the crucial thing here is that the derivative of my position, right, the rate of change of my position, is velocity. So the derivative of P is V.
So I've written that as a derivative statement, but I could also write it as an antiderivative statement.
So I can write that P of T is an antiderivative of V of T, right? Because P differentiates to V, the antiderivative of V is P.
Now I want to use the fact that my velocity at time T is 3 minus 10T.
That means in our specific case that my position being the antiderivative of velocity, and velocity is 3 minus 10t, right? So my position is the antiderivative of my velocity.
And we can solve that antidifferentiation problem.
Well, here we go, right? This is the antiderivative of a difference, which is the difference of antiderivatives. Now, I'd like to antidifferentiate 3. Well, the antiderivative of a constant is just that constant times t. And what's an antiderivative of 10 times t? Well, that's 10 times an antiderivative for t. So I've got 3t minus 10 times. What's an antiderivative for t? By the power rule, an antiderivative for t is t squared over 2. Right? If I differentiate this, I get back t. I'm going to include a plus c here. So I could rewrite this as 3t minus 5t squared plus some constant c.
And now that plus c has a perfectly reasonable physical interpretation. If I know my velocity, I know my position, as long as I know my initial position, as long as I know where I started, right? And that's what that plus c is encoding.
If I knew, for instance, that my position at time 0 were, say, 4 units, then I could figure out what c would have to be, right? That would tell me that my position at some time t would be 3t minus 5t squared plus 4. This is an example where knowing my initial position, my position at time 0, and knowing my velocity for all time is enough to figure out my position.
In very fancy terms, this is an example of solving a differential equation. I started with the derivative information, and by anti-differentiating, I recovered the original function up to a constant.